Amen. God is good. God is good, and today is another day of His goodness and His mercy. God is good. Amen. Let us become more aware of His presence in these days, for His goodness and mercy, says the Word of God, says the goodness and mercy of God follows us through our days. And so we need to stand on that. We need to stand on the goodness and mercy of God by being more aware of His presence. Of His presence. We need more of Your presence, God. We need more of your presence, Lord. We need more of your presence, God. We need more of your presence, Lord. I just want to say that earlier today, while I was sitting with the Lord, just you've learned to practice just to sit and just be with Him. You learn to hear without having to war for it, so to say. You just find a way just to tap in and just listen. Listen. And the Lord today just said, business as usual, huh? Just like that. I hear those spirits saying, business as usual, huh? And I knew exactly what the Spirit was referring to. It was about us conducting our life as usual, as if this moment wasn't taken out for an opportunity to have a visitation with the Lord. And though we're all trying to be productive, I guess, to say, or I don't know. I just feel like we need to be careful that we're not trying to do business as usual. And we need to really know that we are in a moment of time, appointed time with the Lord. And that's what a lot of us are feeling in this season, that we are in a appointed time with the Lord. It's a time set apart to be with Him. And so we want to get in as much as we can. You know, a lot of times those who work full time have said, you know, out of their mouth that they wish they had more time with God. Well, this is the time. This is the time to have more time with God. You know, you've said you've worked too many hours, never had enough time to actually be in His presence. Well, if you have had your job taken away for this season, then this is the time to, you know, mean what you say. And so if you said that, then you should mean that and you should act upon what you meant to say. So take this time, take this season to hear from God like you've always wanted to. I think this is the time to do that. The presence of God is so tangible. And it's so reachable. We would be fools not to look for it. Today's blessing promise is Matthew 7. Seven. We're doing Matthew 7:7. And it says, keep on asking and you will receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking and the door will be open to you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who seeks will find. And to everyone who seeks, finds. And to everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. How amazing is that, that the Lord says, keep asking and you'll receive what you're asking for. Do Just keep seeking and you'll find what you're looking for. Just keep knocking and the door will be open to you. For everyone who asks receives. Everyone who seeks finds. And to everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. I want to give you a simple example of the goodness of God. Not even his goodness. Let me give you an example of the scripture. I found in this season that I've asked and I'm receiving. And I know a lot of other people are too. They're not working, but they're receiving, you know, provision in ways that they never thought they could, because they are asking. And so they're seeking. And so they're finding, and the doors are opening. And it's as simple as I needed an office chair, you know, and today I couldn't take it. I said, God, my butt hurt because the chair is too hard and I can't take it. And I sit here and I do my praying. As you can see, it's my closet. It's my prayer room. It's my office. It's my everything. And so I spend a lot of time in here, and I spend a lot of time on my chair. And then when I can't spend time on my chair, I spend it on the floor, which I don't mind. But the chair was a little bit too much. And I said, God, I need a chair. But we're not in the conditions right now to buy a chair. So, Lord, I need a chair. And then I have not been on OfferUp for so long. I go on there, and this man who's had his chair up for about 4 months, I send him a message, and I'm like, you still have this chair? And he's like, yeah, come get it. And I came to go get the chair. So there you have it. It has cushion. I'm sitting on it right now, and I'm happy. Plus the back support. It has back support. And so ask, seek, and I found. I asked the Lord, God, I need a chair. I sought out for it, and I found it. And now I'm a happy camper, because now I can sit at my chair, at my desk, and not have to feel like I have to rotate myself every 5 minutes. So that is an example of Matthew 7, verse 7. And that's just a natural example. But let's look at a spiritual example. Ask and it shall be given. Ask and it shall be given according to the will of God in the name of Jesus. Under what? Under the direction and guidance and influence of the Holy Spirit, who ask in faith and in submission to the divine will. We should ask in faith. Another scripture says that if you asked in faith, then therefore you thank him as you've already received it. So when we ask the Father, let us go before the Lord. How do we go before the Lord according to the will of God? Simple. Wait for direction, for the guidance, and the influence of the Holy Spirit to come upon you. And you will pray prayers that are faith-filled, not fear-filled. And it would bring you into a submission of his divine will. So what we ask, we receive as a gift. Sometimes we don't even deserve it, but yet God still blesses us. Seek and you shall find. Prayer. Seeking God, his face, his favor, which such shall find who seek in right way by Christ. So in his prayer, in prayer, we're seeking God's face. We're seeking for his favor. And we find it when we seek it in the right way by Christ, with our whole hearts diligently seeking the will of the Father. And then knock and it shall be opened. We should stand at the door and knock. So we stand and knock at the door of mercy. And faith and prayer is the key that opens that door. When our soul finds grace and mercy comes to our help at the time of our need. And so, Lord's design is to express the favor, the consistency of prayer, and to encourage it, because He knows that prayer builds our faith. Prayer is the only thing that can open doors that are unimaginable. Is that right? No, you cannot imagine the doors that God would open up because of prayer, or doors that will open because of prayer, because you come into the agreement between you and the Father and these doors open wide. So what is the promise? The promise is, if you keep praying, then I will keep answering. If you keep seeking, then I will keep showing up. And what was the other thing? And if you keep knocking, then I will open up. And then I think in another note, thinking of it as a twofold, think about how the Lord's always seeking and knocking and looking for us. So what we're doing in the natural is actually something that already happened in the spiritual. We are just now fully coming into that, into something God already poured into. So we're just coming into alignment with something that's already created. And so that is what prayer is about. It's about coming into the fruition, like the wholeness of it, of what God already spoke. And so we're coming into a speaking existence in an unknown place that is waiting for you to grab it, take hold of it, and release it out. So, you know, God does His part. We come into prayer and we take what God has done and we release it. And it manifests itself here on earth. Why? Because in Genesis, it says we had the authority to do so. And so therefore that still exists, because Jesus already made the way. And He already reclaimed that throne so that we may have the freedom we have today. And so today's promise is Matthew 7, verse 7. Seek, knock, and you shall find. Because that is a promise. The Lord says it's that simple. Just keep praying, keep seeking, keep knocking, keep looking, and you'll find it all. Everything you've ever. But I think that we need to come into that place of hunger. Into that place of hunger. Being hungry to find the deep things of God. The depth of the Lord. And when we really get to the relationship where we really want the depth of Jesus. The depth, you know. The length, the width, the depth of it. We're going to find that we had so much more waiting for us. So much more that we could not accomplish without Him. And so let's pray. Father, we just thank You for this time, God. We thank You for Your wisdom, God. Your cloak of wisdom. We thank You, Father, that You're not looking for business as usual. You're looking for sincere, organic soil so that You can plant seeds on good ground. And so, Lord, we just thank You, God. We thank You for Your door of mercy. And we thank You for grace that follows us, God. That is with us, constantly with us, Lord. And so, Lord, I just thank You for Your presence that brings peace in the midst of everything, in the midst of every distraction, every pulling of our families, every demand, every mandate from the world, God. We just thank You that in the midst of that, we can come and sit before You and receive peace. Peace. Peace, peace, peace. To receive peace. Ecclesiastics says that there is a time for war. There's a time to cry. There's a time to laugh. There's a time for joy. Revealing that there's a time for everything. So find your time in this season. Why? What is the Lord asking of you in this time? And do just that. Do just that. Allow the Lord to lead us. Allow the Lord to lead us. And I think that's it. That's all we have for today. Well, be blessed. I will see you again tomorrow, day 18. And we are coming closer. Not halfway there yet, but we will be. And I'm expecting a turnaround for all of us on day 15. Be blessed. Have a good night.